the way you import assets into Katana is by bringing in an Alembic KBC file. So I'll hit tab in the node graph and type in Alembic In and enter. And if I place it in the node graph, it will click on it. I'm just going to remove this part so that it's at the same level as my sphere. And then if I hit this drop down menu and click browse, I can go into my Alembic folder and find the Alembic file that I want. And so if I expand my root node, here you go, you can find your asset in the viewer. So I'm just going to copy this over twice. So I'm just going to bring in my other files, my ground.abc and the coil. So now if I expand this, you can see the assets I've just brought in. I'm just going to be doing a bit of housekeeping now, so I'm going to call this mug. What you can also do is within this drop down menu is say set node from name path, and then if you double click on this you can say coil. And I'm just going to do the same thing for the sphere also, so I'm going to hit say sphere. And there you have it, we have our assets. If I hover over all these nodes and click the, you can see all the other assets I've brought in. What you could also do, however, I'm just going to show you another way in which you can do this, is using an Importomatic node. So this is a super tool, which is just a combination of Alembic In files. If you have look files, you can bring that in, but that's something we'll look into later. So if I expand all this, you can see all the assets that I have within that. But if you jump in, you do Control Minimal Mouse button click to jump in that, and then you expand, and you can see that all that is doing is just bringing in Alembic In file. So this is ultimately doing the same thing at the moment as our Alembic import. So I'm just going to remove that and stick to the Alembic In files.